What would happen if I were to die without a will?
No matter your net worth, it's important to have a basic estate plan in place. Such a plan ensures that your family and financial goals are met after you pass away. You want to ensure your assets go to who you want and how you want. A will or trust tells the world exactly where you want your assets distributed when you are deceased. Dying intestate or dying without a will or trust can be costly to your heirs and leaves you no say over who inherits your assets.
I'm confused as to what I need in my estate plan.
An estate plan has several elements. They include a will, financial power of attorney, living will, and health care power of attorney. For some, a trust may be the best choice. Generally, a living trust is set up to avoid probate.
I think I may have a death tax due to the state or federal government. How do I know?
Many states like New Jersey have a state death tax that affects residents with more than $675,000 in assets, including life insurance. When putting together a plan, you must be mindful of both federal and state laws governing estates. Unfortunately, the tax laws are not designed to benefit you, so your plan must be careful to weave through a maze of complex state and federal tax laws.
Planning my estate seems so overwhelming. Where do I begin?
Taking inventory of your assets is a good place to start. Your assets include your bank accounts, investments, retirement savings, insurance policies, and real estate or business interests. By adding these assets up and subtracting your debts, you can begin to determine whether you have a death tax concern. From there, it's all about deciding who will inherit your hard-earned assets.
I often hear about trusts, but aren't these just for the rich?
Trusts aren't just for the wealthy. Trusts are legal mechanisms that let you put conditions on how and when your assets will be distributed upon your death. They also allow you to reduce your estate and gift taxes and to distribute assets to your heirs without the cost, delay, and publicity of probate court.
I want to leave everything to my spouse, but I've been told to be careful when doing so. What do I need to know?
You may leave an unlimited amount of money to your spouse tax-free, but this isn't always the best tactic. By leaving all your assets to your spouse, you do not use your estate tax exemption, which instead increases your surviving spouse's taxable estate. This means your children are likely to pay more in estate taxes if your spouse leaves them the money when he or she dies. Also, it defers the tough decisions about the distribution of your assets until your spouse's death.
I hear horror stories of families fighting over assets after a loved one has passed. How can I ensure that this will not happen to me?
Discussing your estate plans with your heirs may prevent disputes or confusion. Inheritance can be a loaded issue. By being clear about your intentions, you help dispel potential conflicts after you're gone. In order to plan an estate properly, one must navigate through a complex maze of legal issues. It's always recommended that you seek the advice of a qualified attorney who will take the time to understand your family's issues. Mr. Bonfrisco exclusively focuses his practice in the area of estate planning and probate to better serve his clients. Mr. Bonfrisco takes the time to design a well-crafted estate plan designed specifically for your needs. Choose Simeone and Bonfrisco for your estate planning needs.